Futility by Wilfred Owen, 1893 to 1918. Move him into the sun. Gently, its touch awoke him once. At home, whispering of fields unsown. Always it woke him, even in France, until this morning and this snow. If anything might rouse him now, the kind old sun will know. Think how it wakes the seeds, woke once the clays of a cold star. Are limbs so dear achieved, are sides full nerved, still warm, too hard to stir? Was it for this the clay grew tall? Oh, what made fatuous sunbeams toil to break earth's sleep at all? Okay, this poem is by Wilfred Owen. Wilfred Owen came from Shropshire in the UK. He's known as one of the war poets, one of the poets criticizing the futility and the loss of life during the First World War, where hundreds of thousands, no, millions of people died. And effectively, this is what this poem is about. It's talking about a soldier who has died. Notice Owen himself was killed near the end of the First World War. Let's see, this poem is in the form of an elegy. An elegy is a poem or dedicated to somebody who has died. And I think you could also call the poem a lament as well. It's an expression of grief about or sadness that this person has died. Yeah. And here Owen is talking about the loss of this soldier and how sad it is that he has gone. So move him into the sun. So I think they're wondering if he's dead. He's clearly been the soldier has clearly been wounded. Yeah. Gently its touch awoke him once. At home, whispering of fields unsown, always it woke him, even in France, until this morning and this snow. So move him into the sun, put him in the sunshine. Let's see if the sunshine can wake him. I think they're still hoping that he's alive, that he hasn't been killed, and that the sun can bring him back. It's like the sun is the god that gave us life, a god that could give its life, give life back to this soldier. But very clearly, they know this soldier is dead. And move him into the sun, because the sun, its touch awoke him once. Okay, so I think here this is talking about the sun being the giver of life. Without a sun, there would be no life on this planet. And so the sun is the giver of food. And the sun awoke him once, it woke him up. At home, whispering of fields unsown. So here the fields unsown. So you sow seeds in a field. And I think this, the unsown fields, this is talking about the life that this young soldier has not been able to live. He hasn't been able to sow his wild oats. He hasn't been able to had time to create anything. So the this soldier, he's been awakened or the sun gave him life, and now he's been killed before he's had time to give fruit back to the land. Always it woke him, even in France until this morning and this snow. So the sun has always woken him. Yeah, it's something that wakes us all. We're animals of the day. And it's woken him every morning, but not today, not this snowy day in France. Now he's dead. If anything might rouse him now, the kind old sun will know. So if anything could give life back to him, maybe the sun will know how to do it. So here, the sun, the kind old sun, the giver of life, the giver of creation, will know how to wake him, how to give life back to him, because clearly we don't. Think how it wakes the seeds. So here, the sun, when spring comes, the seeds germinate, and the sun knows how to germinate seeds. Woke once the clays of a cold star. So let's see, the earth, I think here he's referring to the earth as the clays of a cold star. And all creation, all living things have come from the clay of this planet, from the earth of this planet. From the dust of this planet, which is effectively the clay of a cold star. And the sun has given birth to all of the life on Earth. The sun is the giver of life, and maybe the sun knows how to give life back to this soldier. Yeah, because the sun knows how to create life from the clay that we are made of. Our limbs so dear achieved, our sides full nerved, still warm, too hard to stir. So if the sun can make life, then is it so difficult for the limbs, the arms and the legs? Is it so dear achieved, so difficult to achieve? Yeah, are sides full nerved, so full feeling, and is it difficult to give life back to this person, this poor soldier? Yeah, he's still warm. Yeah. Yeah, is it hard to give life back to him, to bring it back? I'm sure the sun knows how to do it. And here it's echoing the desperation that they want this person to come back to life. And this is, I think, echoing how unfair it is that this young man has been cut down by war. Was it for this the clay grew tall? Now, this here is saying, was the idea that man was created, that life was created from the clay, and life stood up, and man became civilized, and was all this just for this poor soldier to be cut down and killed? Yeah. Is this really the object of creation? Yeah, why did God, the sun, bother making man if he's only going to be killed again like this in war? Oh, what made fatuous sunbeams toil to break earth's sleep at all? And here it's saying the same thing. Why did God decide to make the sun work to give life to the creation on this planet, to make human beings? Yeah, why have the sunbeams, has the sun been shining to break the sleep of Earth, to give life to Earth, if this is going to happen? Yeah, if this. He's here, he's saying that this is a senseless death. So, enough. If you enjoyed the video, give it a rating, subscribe to my channel, and I will see you soon. Bye for now. Futility by Wilfred Owen.